Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Myself Dr. Surbhi Sahni. Hope you are doing great. On your request, I come forward with the first year lecture, and today I'm going to talk about a lecture on carbohydrates. Already one lecture is out on biochemistry, that is regarding the classification of the carbohydrates. Now today in this video I'm going to talk about the biochemistry of the monosaccharides, which is the first type of the carbohydrates, right? Carbohydrate is the first year very important chapter of biochemistry, important for the first year BDS student as well as for the MBBS student also. It is important for your chemistry theory exam as well as for the Viva. If you haven't checked out the earlier video regarding the classification of the carbohydrate, do check out this video. I will definitely put the link of this video in the I button as well as the link in the description of this video. Now today we are going to talk about the structural aspects, that means the biochemistry of the monosaccharide, the first type of the carbohydrate. There are few terms or the few phenomena which come under the category of the biochemistry of monosaccharides. So take a pen and paper and at least note down few terms first and try to learn it, just a term. In this video, we will discuss everything in detail along with the strategy or the tips and tricks to learn the biochemistry in the best way. So it's my request that you can take pen and paper and note down certain words which are related to the biochemistry of the monosaccharides. The first one is the chiral carbon. The second word is the apomers. Third word is the asymmetric carbon atom. Fourth word is the stereoisomerism. Fifth word is the fissure projections or the fissure phenomena. What is the isomers? Definitely you all have a curiosity in your mind that why there is a dictation, what is going on in chemistry. See, while you begin with the learning part or the understanding part of the chemistry, you need to learn the terms first so as you can know the meaning later on once you understand this lecture very well. So without wasting time, let's start with the first term in detail. First term is the asymmetric carbon atom. What is that? As you can see in the picture, asymmetric carbon atom is defined as those carbon atom or the carbon group which is attached to the four different functional groups or the four different groups is there. As you can see in this picture, this carbon is attached to the four different groups which is shown on your screen. So that's why it is known as the asymmetric carbon atom. Second term is, what is isomer? Isomer is defined as those compounds or the molecules which has same molecular formula but different structural formula. Let's see deep into it, because monosaccharide shows one of its category. Like isomers has further divided into different types, and out of which their one type is stereoisomerism, which is our next term. Understand this isomers or the stereoisomerism, all you need to take an example of butyrhalide molecule. As you can see in the picture, the left hand side there is the hydrogen group and on the right hand side there is the hydroxyl group. If we see just the mirror image of this molecule, then we will see that on the right hand side it is the hydrogen group and on the left hand side there is the hydroxyl group, right? So this tendency of the molecule or this combination or the this pair is known as the optical isomers. So from this we conclude that those molecules which has the same molecular formula but different structural formula are known as stereoisomerism. Now there is one confusion. Even I said the isomer is also same and the stereoisomerism is also same, then what is the difference between two? See, the main term is isomers and the stereoisomerism is just the subtype of that. This is the first difference. Second difference is, in case of the stereoisomerism, the OH group and the hydrogen group, that means the difference of the position of the hydroxyl group and the hydrogen group is on the different positions of the asymmetric carbon atom. That means, as you can see in the picture, the example of the glucose and the fructose. If you see the molecular formula of the glucose and the fructose, it is C6H12O6, right? Same for the glucose and same for the fructose. But when we come to the structures of the glucose and fructose, you can see the carbon, which is having the four different groups or connected with the four different groups. There are the presence of the asymmetric carbons in this structure, which is shown on your screen. As you can see, second, third, fourth and fifth carbon atom. In the case of the structure of the glucose, there are four asymmetric carbon atom. And on the other hand, if you see the structure of the fructose, then the carbon which is present on the third position carbon, fourth position carbon and the fifth position carbon are the asymmetric carbon atoms, right? So there are the three asymmetric carbon atoms present in case of the fructose. And you can very well appreciate the position of the hydroxyl group as well as the hydrogen group in both the structures, which is shown on your screen. So that's why they are the very good example of the stereoisomerism. Now, how you can find out how many stereoisomerism is there? So, to process to find out that is known as on the basis of the asymmetric carbon atom, and which is known as the chiral carbon atom. That means the second name of the asymmetric carbon atom is the chiral carbon atom. So, from this we get the phenomena, what is chirality? To find out the chirality of a molecule, there is one rule, that it is denoted as 2 raised to power n. Now, what is n? N is defined as the presence of the chiral carbon atom, or we can say the presence of the asymmetric carbon atom. As I have told you few seconds back, just an example of glucose and fructose, you can see that in the case of glucose, there are four chiral atoms, or we can say the four asymmetric atoms. So we can write its chirality as 2 raised to power 4. That means you have to multiply 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. That means there are total 16 stereoisomers in case of the glucose. On the other hand, see the example of the fructose, then here you can find the three chiral atoms, or we can say the three asymmetric atoms, right? Then there you can find it out to be right as its chirality as 2 raised to power 3. That means 2 into 2 into 2. That will give rise to 2 to the 4 and 4 to the 8. That means there, in case of fructose, there are 8 stereoisomers. Saccharides definitely show the stereoisomerism, so that's why it is very important to understand the stereoisomerism, right? Second property, they show the chirality, so the term chirality is also very important to understand. Now, followed by that, we have come across the third category or the third phenomena, or we can say the third aspects of the monosaccharide, D and L isomers. Now, what is that? They are nothing, just a little difference in their structure give the representation as DLN appearance of the structure. As you can see in the picture, the first picture, if the OH group is present on the right side, then it is known as D glucose, right? And if the OH group is present on the left side, then it is known as the L glucose. So the DLN isomers are just this, nothing else. And the DLL isomers with a new example. Let's see, this is just a new molecule as an example, right? Now, how you will come across to know that it is the D isomers or the L isomers? For that, you need to note that from the functional group you have to go down till the functional skeletal of the carbon, right? And there you will find the chiral carbon atom, or we can say the asymmetric carbon atom, right? You have to check the position of the functional group. That is, if the hydroxyl group is present on the right, then it is known as the D isomers. And if the OH group is present on the left, then it is known as the L isomers. So as you can see in this new example, it is the D isomer, right? Now we come to the next phenomena, which is the last structural aspect of the monosaccharides, that is epimers. Now the most important and the viva question is, what is epimers? Epimers are nothing, they are just the sugar compounds, or we can say the monosaccharides, which are different in the configuration but only and only around the one special carbon atom. Now to understand this, we have to take another example of glucose and mannose. As you can see the structure of the glucose and mannose, you can find out that there is only just a difference at the second carbon atom, and that's why mannose is the epimer of glucose structure. So with this, that's all about the first part of the biochemistry of the monosaccharides. Hope you understand it very well. All these terms are important for your viva if you are giving the biochemistry viva, or if there is a long question which will definitely come in your theory exam of biochemistry, then you need to understand and write it in your exam for sure. So that's why this topic is very, very important. If you still have any query, you can drop me the mail which is shown on your screen, and don't forget to follow me on my Instagram ID which is shown on your screen. And if you want the notes regarding this topic, you can DM me anytime on my Instagram ID and can get the notes regarding this topic too. Don't forget to hit the like button to this video, and if you are new on my channel, do subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon and press all, because that will give you the notification of my upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.